please.
Hi, I'm Kirogo from Center for Aviation Innovation Research. Before studying, talking about my research, I want to think why science lab is needed. Because people think science is difficult to understand. And if all the science is like you guys, then people will understand. Science is not difficult, but science is needed for our life. And if policymakers have the chance to hear from all of your scientists, like Science Lab, what you are researching, then policymakers can make better policies too, don't you think? So we want to policymakers to understand more about what is going on in science and engineering fields. And so anyway, so you're most of our scientists and researchers. You pay a lot of efforts to write papers and patents. And when your efforts are published, you should be very happy. But you should be more happy if your paper and patents are read by someone. But now, information is flooding, and every day a lot of papers and patents are published. So sometimes your paper will not be read by someone. It's very sad. So what I'm doing is I want highlight your efforts, and I want that people can use your knowledge in good way. So what I do is to structure information. If I can structure paper information and patent information, and if we can make a landscape or map, then a policymaker can notice that, wow, in Japan, such research is going on, and in America, they are very strong in this place. And also, it should be good for your researchers, because you sometimes focus on your field, so you don't know what is going on in the lab next to you. So if we can facilitate getting information easier, and we can promote innovation from you too. But I don't think you really understand what I'm doing, because I don't visualize what I'm doing now. So maybe I want to visualize this by PowerPoint. Works. So can you? So what do you think this? It's knowledge. Knowledge is beautiful. It's actually, this is a fire. It's like a firework, but it's aeronautic papers. There are like 30,000 of papers are here. But even I'm a researcher at aeronautic area, but I never read all the papers. So what I do is focus on the citation between papers and visualize them. Structure them to the group. So what kind of research is going on right now? Then, using the text mining, we can identify what kind of research each are. So there are flight control research and material control research and also some specific fluid dynamics researches. So we can make a map of researches. Then, what's the benefit? As I said, if you're policymakers, well, we can notice which area is now emerging area, or which area is old fashion area. So, policymakers can notice that, well, in Japan, maybe these areas are strong, or maybe we should have a strategy to grow this area. And as I said, if you're a researcher, and if you're a researcher of this area, why don't you think about the area very far from your area, so that you can have a new idea to make a solution for your problem. So, and to use the map is depending on your users. And I tried to make our measurement how to highlight right information, how to highlight emerging area, how to highlight very strong area. So that's the overview of my research.
Thank you very much.